Hi, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how you can get a multi-channel audio mastering workflow for Premiere Pro CS6. So what is multi-channel audio? Well, we're all familiar with mono audio being a single channel and stereo being two, and as the name suggests, multi-channel is more than that, up to 16 per media file. I'll show you how you can create submixes in your sequence and how you can set up the audio mixer in Premiere Pro to support a multi-channel setup. How you can separate out the elements such as dialogue, spot effects, Atmos and music into their own submixes, and then how you send those submixes to the dedicated channels in the multi-channel master. And the reason you're going to want to do this is that at some point in the future, after you've created your mix, somebody may need to change the balance of dialogue, spot effects, Atmos and music at some later date and doesn't have access to the full edited file. This is after you've done your mastering. But you'll want to create a stereo submix, which is the balance that you're working towards for your edit. So I'll show you how you can create a stereo submix as well as the separated out channels. Also, I'll show a variation on how you can create a pre-fader multi-channel mix, which will be best explained as we go through this tutorial. Okay, so let's go over to Premiere Pro. So the first thing we're going to do is create a new sequence. So it doesn't matter which preset you choose, just click on the tracks tab at the top here, and where you've got the audio master section, the default is stereo, change that to multi-channel and leave that at 16. You can give it a name for this demo. We're just going to click OK at that point. And I've got some clips here. One clip is a video with four mono tracks, so I'm just going to drag that onto this timeline just to create some content. I'll keep the existing settings that we just set up. And I'm just going to adjust this. This is the master mixer that you normally see right over the side with just two channels. I just want to make it a little bit bigger so we can fully see which ones are actually in use. Okay, and I'm just going to drag some music down here onto another channel. So if I press play on the timeline, you can see that everything is playing exactly where you'd expect it on channels 1 and 2, which would be our stereo mix. So let's go to the audio mixer and we'll see what's going on here. Press play and you can see all of that, and here's the master levels over here. That's not what we want. We want to separate these out, as we've said. So what we're going to do is create some submixes. So if we right click in the channel tracks here and add tracks, you don't want any video tracks, you don't actually want any audio tracks. What we would like to do is create three submix tracks. And what we're going to do, it's going to be slightly cut down from the overview I gave earlier. We're going to create one set of channels for dialogue, one set of channels for the music, and we're going to create a stereo mix as well. So let's click OK there. And you can see these have now popped up into the mixer. So let's just go and rename these. So this one we'll call Dialogue Mix. This one we're going to call, if I can select it, Music Mix. And this one will be our stereo mix there. Fantastic. So press play, nothing's actually happening to these yet. So what we need to do is reassign these channels here. So we know that audio channels 1, 2, 3 and 4 we've already set up a dialogue, so let's just send those over to the dialogue mix by changing their assignment at the top here. And audio channel 5 we know was the music that we dragged in, so let's change that to music mix. And again, now if we press play, you can see the two mixes are working as desired, but we still only have two channels over here and they're both in the stereo pair. So we've got our stereo mix, but we still haven't got the separated tracks. If you look here, the default is 1 and 2, so we can basically redirect the output assignment to 3 and 4 for our dialogue and 5 and 6 for our music track. So that's now we get those here. But we don't have a stereo mix. You've kind of fixed one problem and created another problem. But what we want to do is send some of this signal and some of this signal to the stereo submix. So if we click the disclosure at the top here, this little triangle, we can see the effects and sends area. Let's just drag this down so we can see the channel names. And oops, that's now messed up the mixer, so I just need to go there. Right. So what we want to do is send some of this dialogue to the stereo mix. And by default, it's going to send nothing. So you have to click in here and set that to 0 dB. And we're going to send the music channel to the stereo mix. And again, set that to 0 dB. And we can see that the stereo mix by default went to 1 and 2. So now when we press play, you can see that we've got 3 and 4, 5 and 6. So we've got dialogue and music, and we've got a mixture of the channels going to the stereo. So now if we drag, say, one of these down, you can see that, you know, the whole mix, that's now looking more like the dialogue. And conversely, if I change the dialogue mix, it's more like the music. So you can see that these are actually definitely both going to the stereo mix. Just put that at the beginning. But what happens is if later on in the, you know, in the edit process, you know, post you completing the project, you've decided, actually, I don't want this music in here, so you drop it down, so you've just got dialogue there, and they decided they wanted that music back. Well, we haven't got those in those channels because this is affected by the fader. So these faders create the stereo mix. So if I drag that right to the top, you can see that it's affecting channels 1 and 2 as well. But it's also affecting the individual output channels, which is not the ideal kind of scenario. So what we're going to do is we're going to create the mix in a slightly different way to create what's called a pre-faded mix. So first of all, I'm just going to just rename this one to Dialogue Submix. You'll see why in a second. And this is going to be sent to master 1 and 2, so that's going to go to the stereo mix. And this here is going to send everything to this dialogue submix. It will all make sense. For this one, we want to create a new stereo submix. I'm going to change this one to be called the music submix. Music submix, and again we're going to send 0 dBs to there. Okay, so we've got 1 and 2. I also want this to go to 1 and 2 now, so these are back to the stereo mix as we had before. But the dialogue and the music, we want to assign those to their respective, oops, that's 3 and 4 and 5 and 6. But you probably realize that that's not going to make much of a difference. Okay, so we've got our stereo mix, and again, if I change this music mix, we've lost the whole thing again. So it's not really affected or carried out what we wanted. So the way to do this, if you right click and click pre-fader, right click pre-fader, what this now does is sends the signal from these channels to the submixes over here before you've actually change these faders. So this allows you now to create this stereo mix. You can see, so our stereo mix now has got no music in it, but the music is still blaring away on channels 5 and 6. So if somebody later on wanted to remix this, they've got access to the full channel capability over here. So let's just put that back to normal. But you still get your stereo submix. So when you render out, you will get your stereo submix as you intended. So that concludes this tutorial. I hope that's been of some use. Bye-bye for now.